Summertime riding on sugar low. People tryna flag me down the beat they going. Yelling out the window at me, cigarettes, bitch. Be proud of your homie, keep it going. And my reaction, I'm responding in the ear, rubber shield, shopping meals, shopping off of Manhattan. Fans asking me shit while I'm picking out clothes. Used to wish that I'd be famous for this rapping and it happened. Homie said I'm snapping, I dabbed them up. Took a pic for Instagram and sunglasses, so I told them post it up and tag me, bro. I follow back, spread the word, I don't ask for much, and that's some real shit. One of my friends said that's like a daughter deal with. Fuck no, man, I'm still kids. Lord, 5 years down the road from now, but when it's over, I ain't about to suffer up until then. People staring at me in the restaurant. On the days of 1 or 2, nobody knows me. But when I'm in my comfy clothes and leave the house, someone gonna notice me and come approach. I see a kid walk up to a table. My girlfriend said, fuck, she ain't grateful. She just hated she can't leave the house without a makeup. People post shit on Facebook and then upset us something hateful. Homie wasn't trying to take a pic of us. He said, I can't believe it, you, I keep on bitching stuff. Your music got me doing stuff.
I do is work on cars all day and then go home and work on this car. When I was 14 years old, I started working on cars. I was I think an eighth grader in high school. I got to meet a lot of people that I socialized with every day and learn from, just gained a lot of knowledge from. The most difficult challenges for me, especially in my younger days when I first started working on cars, was the financial stability. I wanted to do so much with my cars. But just being a kid in high school, not having a job really, was kind of like out of weight, you know. Basically, I never expected it to look like this. Like, it was just gonna be my daily driver. I was just planning on building a different car that I had. I wanted to build that one, but I just little by little started working on this one, wanted to make it look clean. And then when I saw the vision in my head, it was just like, it was nothing close to this. This is by far exceeded my own expectations. I mean, I would just tell them, just keep that dream, keep that drive, like shoot what you want, envision that, and you can achieve it. A good friend of mine, Doug Widener, he's from Washington, who I met over Facebook, which is a really great friend of mine now. Seeing his wagon was somewhat of my vision for this car. Once I saw it, I was like, I want that. I want my car to look like that, and I just stuck with it. And these are the results. Just sticking with it, going for it. Just, it's not gonna be an easy road. This is 4 years in the making. So it's not an overnight thing. It's nothing like that. Just be patient and with time you'll get it. Here in Vegas and in Bakersfield, this year was the first time I won my first two trophies ever. Best display and best old school Honda. I've also done 360 car show. Big shout out to Jesse for those events. Those are all charity events. I love doing those. I've also done Elite Tuner here in Vegas. Shout outs to my biggest supporter, which is my wife, mainly my wife. She has always supported me in everything I've done. My team, Street Symphony. This build wasn't, you know, done just by myself. Street Symphony had a big part of it. Jamie, President Kevin King, my boy Charles Daniels for the exhaust, Ion for the wheels, just everybody in general. Racing Source for hooking me up with some parts. Big shout out to my family for supporting me, you know, everybody on social media that I've met through this build. Just big shout out to everybody. Just really appreciate the love and support that I've gotten from everybody. And I just look forward to seeing how farther I can go with this.
Sweet. That was it. Thanks, man.
Cool.